Good morning, children. Welcome back with the next new session. So in this session, we are going to discuss the lesson so far we have started, that is lesson number 22, rulers and buildings. So far in this lesson, we have discussed about the temples that have constructed early in the 11th century. We have discussed the new way of building. We have also discussed about the buildings and mosques of mosques and tanks. We have also discussed about the destructions of temples. So in this part of the session, we are going to discuss the imperial part of Vijayanagara temples. So in the Vijayanagara period, what are the temples and what style these temples were made? We are going to discuss in this session. Okay. So firstly, we all know in the previous lessons of Vijayanagara, we have learned that Vijayanagara, where the Rayas, that means the people in the kingdom are known as the Rayas. So they have followed a different type of construction method that they have followed in their kingdom. So their kingdom's map also we have seen, whereas there are some fortified walls, there are some moat walls where the kingdom is placed in one side, the agriculture is placed in the, that means the agriculture lands are placed in one side, the main roads are in one side. Okay, the temples of Lord Shiva, that means the Virupaksha, is built in their capital city, is all we have learned in their lesson of Vijayanagara kingdom, isn't it? So what happened is they focused more on the temples where the temple of the style of making temples are either of Gopuram model or either of Vimanas model. So these two kinds of styles were being focused. I mean, these two models are being very much very much important, or they had a lot of interest in these kind of models. So what they have done is most of the temples what they have built were the Raya Gopurams only. So that means the top of the temples were it is all designed with the idols of gods, and step by step it is all built. Okay, so such temples are known as Raya Gopurams. You can see the temple of Tirupati. Okay, how it is made? The temple of Sri Sailam. So how it is made? It's all the name of Raya Gopurams. That means it is the roof of the temple is known as Gopuram. So whereas on the name of Vijayanagara king Sri Krishna Devaraya, so on his name, dedicated to his name, so Raya Gopurams were been seen on the different famous temples. Okay, then these temples, in the first floor of these temples were made of stones, that means the marble kind of stones were used, whereas following the next floors of these temples were made with the plaster ones, which is known as sunnam in Telugu. Okay, so made of bricks and sunnam. Okay, so the next other floors were made of that. Okay, then I'll be showing you a image of a temple. Okay, this is a temple of Virupaksha in Hampi. Okay, this is a temple of Virupaksha. So see the temple here. So this is the Gopuram, which is known as Raya Gopuram. That means step by step is constructed like this. And see, this is the entrance one. This is the entrance gate. And these are all the pillars which have been towards like both the sides of the temple. Now when it is entrance, all these areas are used by the people who come here to visit. Okay, people usually sit here. People usually, when the programs like yagnyas or homas, or sometimes the music or dances are all performed in this. So when you enter this temple, you can find here there is a small entrance gate here in the temple there. Inside that there is a huge hall. So there is a big hall inside it. And whereas to the end of it, you can find the main god, that is Lord Virupaksha. Okay, that means Lord Shiva. So they have also dedicated temples on the names of gods of goddesses Krishna. Okay, that means the name of Vithala is the name of Krishna only. Okay, so Lord Sri Rama, Lord Sri Krishna, Virupaksha are some of the temples they have built. That means the Vijayanagara kingdom are interested in building. So this kind of the style of their building is either Gopuram style or either as the Vimana style. So apart from all these two styles, there were one more style that these people have followed. So they have followed the Sultanate style also. So what is Sultanate style is, to their temples or to their forts, they have to the roof of that, you can see there are some dome kind of thing. Dome means nothing but a half semicircle kind of the roofs were made. I'll show you the image of that. And following that, the entrance gate are like the arches. So like how the Muslim masjids are, how you can see the entrance gate are masjids. So that kind of an architecture was also been adopted by the Vijayanagara kingdom from the Sultanate style of modeling. Okay, so I'll show you the image of that as well. So this is this one. See, you can see that there is a dome kind of a structure on the top of that, whereas okay, this is the top of that, whereas you can see the entrance of every dome, it is an arch shape ones. So this is a sultanate model. So this is known as the elephant's table. So this was one of the monument what this Vijayanagara kingdom, what the Vijayanagara people have built. Then this style is known as sultanate style. Okay, elephant's stable. And one more is the lotus temple. Okay, the lotus temple, even that was been created with the same style of sultanate model. Okay, if you have seen the this lotus temple like image, you can see that there are some domes and some arches which have been used for making of this lotus temple. Then when you see this image carefully, see the top of that are similar to the gopurams that we have in our Hindu temples, like the Tirupati temples, how there were some gopurams are there. In the same way, these gopurams are also there. So this elephant stable is also made of the plaster as well as the bricks and the sunnam what we have discussed earlier. So this is also made like that only. Okay, then so I'll be showing one more image. So this is an image of Mahanavi Dibba. So this is known as Mahanavi Dibba. So it's look at the height. It is a height of some 5 feet, some 5-floor building. Okay, this is an height of 5-floor building. Okay, and it is of 11,000 square kilometers. This is 5-floor height, and this is the area of it. It is 11,000 square kilometers. Okay, then next what is there is, so what is this, what is Mahanavi Dibba? So this is the thing which is built by the Vijayanagara kingdom. So what it is used for is, so usually when it's the festival of Dasara, that means the Durga Puja, what happens is these people place the idols of goddesses Durga in the center, like it is used as a stage. So the goddesses Durga and other idols were placed here on the stage, and it is roofed, that means it is covered with the pandals. Okay, what is pandal means, like we say, you know, like in every festival before the Hindu houses we have, you know, with the cloth shamianas. So that kind of shamianas or the pandals were being covered on the roof, and the idols were been stood here. Okay, and these are covered with the shamianas. So how the shamianas are been placed, so that there will be some 4 wooden poles will be there on the 4 edges, and covered, and it gives the support to the shamiana. You might have seen in most of the festivals people before their houses, or people, they put these kind of a shamianas and pandals. So to cover this, the shamianas and the pandals are used. Then the idols were used, especially during the Durga Puja. So these people of Vijayanagara, they placed the goddesses here. Okay, so along with the Vijayanagara, along with the kings in the Vijayanagara, the other Nayakas, we have already discussed, no, in the lesson of Vijayanagara kings, there were some Nayakas in their kingdom. So along with their Nayakas and some other royal families, they all come together, they join together, and they celebrate the festival of Durga Puja here. The royal families as well as the Nayakas contribute some of their contributions. It may be of wealth, or it may be of money, or it may be any kind of fruits or whatever that they can provide, they just devote it to the goddesses here during Durga Puja. So this is known as Mahanavi Dibba, which is made by Vijayanagara kingdom. Okay, then I hope you have all clear till here. Now we are going to discuss about the gardens, tombs and forts. Gardens, tombs and forts. Okay, so gardens, so what garden is, we all know the garden is a place where the land is covered with the grasses, okay, which are trimmed ones, which are in a beautiful way. Okay, then there are some flower plants, beautiful flowers, beautiful different kinds of flowers are all made. Then what is a tomb and what is a fort? We all know forts means, fort is a place where usually the kings live, usually with the kings along with the soldiers live. And what are tombs? Tombs are also similar there, where the soldiers live. Okay, so now we are going to talk about the gardens, tombs and the forts which are made by the Mughals especially. So the Mughals, they had a lot of interest in the literature. Mughals had a lot of interest in their literature. But Babur, one of the first Mughal emperor, okay, Babur, he has described in his biography that they had also an interest on the buildings, also buildings of monuments. Okay, one among them, the Mughal emperor, only one among the Mughal emperor has also built the seven wonder, that is Taj Mahal, which is also built by the Mughal only. Okay, the Red Fort is a beautiful monument which was made by them. Okay, the Lal Killa is also like the Lal Killa, that means the Red Fort. Okay, the Qutub Minar, these are all the monuments which are being made by the Mughals only. Then they had a lot of interest in the literature as well as in the art and architecture also. So when we talk about architecture, they plan of preparing or they plan of designing the building is of a different model. Okay, when we talk about the arches and the domes that the Vijayanagara have adopted from the Mughals, so that is the first concept, the first type of architecture what the Mughals have introduced in the Indian, in India. Firstly, these peoples have started the concept of using domes and the arches, that means the entrance gate. So that is been adopted, or you can say it is a copied one from the Mughal Empire only. Then these people have also planned in such a way that every monument, before the monument, there are some gardens and there are some channel waterways. So what is channel waterways? That means a small passage of water going. Okay, like water passes in the garden. Okay, so this is known as Chahar Bagh. So what is Chahar Bagh is, what they do is, they take an entire garden, divide it into four equal parts, and among all these parts, there's a small channels were made where water usually passes. You might have seen the monument of Taj Mahal, where you can also see that there were water channels where the water is passing. Okay, I'll just show you the image, you'll have a clear clarity of that. See, this is one of the Chahar Bagh. See, where the garden is all divided into four parts and the water is passing hereby. Okay, so and the water is all passing hereby. So this is the Babar is supervising, that means instructing the workers how to prepare the Chahar Bagh and what is the architecture method that they have to use. Okay, and this is an image of Humayun's tomb. Okay, this is a tomb. Okay, so what is tomb, you ask, you know? So this is a tomb, where a tomb is a building or an architecture where these are all different rooms, or you can say different halls, where a fortified pillars are there. So all these is a places where the entrance, you can see there are some channels here. See, a small passage of water is there. So this is known as the channels where the water usually passes. So why these Mughal people, why did they what is the reason of making all these kind of monuments? Because usually their halls or their places were not only just like, you can say, if you talk about Taj Mahal, so people say Taj Mahal is a beautiful monument made of marble. Okay, inside if you go to the Taj Mahal, you can see only the grave of Shah Jahan's wife Mumtaz, isn't it? But no, if you see that may be dedicated to that, but apart from the other architectures what this Mughal have made, so lot of halls, lot of community halls were also been made by these Mughals. If you focus on, so these halls are mostly made for the worship, for the community discussions. So whatever the discussions are required, these discussions were made. Then apart from the discussions, there were some places where these people come and worship also. Okay, the place where they come and worship, that means the place where the king's throne is all kept, that means if it is a community hall. Okay, if it is a community hall which was made by Mughals, so if it's a big hall, so what happens, like a court, like the king's court, we might have seen king's court, no? The king is sitting in the middle and both the sides the other ministers are sitting in a row, isn't it? So in the same way, when the Mughals design the same kind of architecture, the place where the king's throne is kept is known as Qibla. Q-I-B-L-A. Qibla is a place where the king's throne is kept, and the long hall is there where the people come and bow and they worship their god there. Okay, so this kind of an architecture is also been made by them. The Chahar Bagh concept is also been made by the Mughals only. So now I'll show you an image of the same Chahar Bagh, which is before the beautiful image of Taj Mahal, beautiful monument of Taj Mahal. You can see the Chahar Bagh, that means the garden is divided into four parts, and see the symmetric kind of an architecture, symmetric kind of a design what these people have made, how these people have divided the park into the garden into four equal parts, and how the symmetric design, that means of squares, rectangles, are all kind of symmetric models are all used, where the water goes and water passes from these. And this is the dome one, these are the pillars, and this is the entrance of the Taj Mahal. Mahal, beautiful monument. Okay, so and this Chaharbagh and the Babur has instructed that only he can live on, like he along with his family can live near the such monuments where the Chaharbagh kind of a monuments, like Chaharbagh kind of an architecture is placed. Okay, no other like no other member from his family, especially the other sons among his family, are not allowed to be near the river Yamuna. Okay, not allowed to stay near the river Yamuna, and they cannot create their own Chaharbagh, and they are not allowed to stay there. Only the eldest son, that is eldest son of Babur, was only allowed to build his house or build his fort near the river Yamuna and can stay there. Okay, so this was all about the lesson, rulers and building. This was the last part of the lesson. I hope you understood it very well. So this was about this session. So for any more doubts and queries, please ask us immediately. We'll meet up in the next upcoming session with a fresh new lesson. Till then, bye children. Thank you. Have a nice day.